In this screencast, we will look at water as a condensable species. In many systems, water is present in a gas stream and can be condensed out. So let's make our system. Let's say we have a dehumidifier. And coming in, we have a stream of water and air. Coming out, we have a stream of water and air. But we've condensed out some of the water from the air. So let's say that, for the sake of this dehumidifier, that the water and air comes in at 30 degrees C and it's saturated with water. The dehumidifier operates at 15 degrees C on the inside. And we can think of the dehumidifier as basically having a water phase of condensed water and a gas phase. We also know that our system is going to be at 1 atmosphere. So what we're interested in calculating is the mole fraction of water in the air coming in versus the mole fraction of the water in the air coming out. And the equation that we're going to use to solve this is a limiting case of Raoult's law. Raoult's law is used to relate the composition of the gas to its saturation pressure. So what Raoult's law tells us is that yi, the molar composition of component I in the gas phase, times the total pressure of the system equals the saturation pressure at a certain temperature of component I. So in the case of this system, we're interested in calculating yi coming in and out of the system. So we can solve for the fact that yi equals pi saturation at a certain temperature divided by the total pressure of the system. So now we can find what the composition is coming into and out of the dehumidifier. So first let's calculate the molar composition of the water and air coming in to the system. So to do this, we're going to need to look up the saturation pressure of water at 30 degrees C. So to do this, we're going to use table B3 from Felder and Rousseau, Elementary Principles of Chemical Processes, 3rd edition. And when we go to this table, we can see that for 30 degrees, come down to 30, and then 0 in the decimal place, that the saturation pressure of water at 30 degrees is 31.824 millimeters of mercury. So now that we have the saturation pressure of water, we can use it to calculate the mole fraction of water in the incoming stream. So yi is going to equal 31.824 millimeters of mercury divided by our atmospheric pressure, which we were told is 1 atm, which is equivalent to 760 millimeters of mercury. And from this calculation, we can see that we have 0.041 moles of water per total moles. Next, let's calculate the composition of water in the gas coming out of the dehumidifier. So now we can see that our temperature has decreased, and PI sat, we need to find out what it is at 15 degrees Celsius, because the dehumidifier has cooled off our system. So again, we go to table B3 from Felder and Rousseau. And here in table B3, we can find that at 15 degrees, the saturation pressure of water is 12.788 millimeters of mercury. So using the same equation for our input water stream, we can see now that yi is going to equal 12.788 millimeters of mercury divided by, again, our total 760 millimeters of mercury of total pressure. And this is going to give us now that the mole fraction of water and air is 0.0168 moles of water per total moles. So as we can see, the dehumidifier has successfully decreased the mole fraction of water and air from our input to our output. And we can also see that Raoult's law is a useful way to turn partial pressure into a mole fraction when we have water in a system.